This is a background of banking API in Japan. In Japan, there is a regulation. The revised banking act was published in last year to promote API. And more than 80% of banks will open API within this within 1.5 years. And about security, OAuth 2.0 is described as a key technology. This is the first figure of report from Japanese Bankers Association. This says the basic framework uses OAuth 2.0. However, OAuth is only a part of API security. This slide shows the authentication and authorization of API. As you know, OAuth is only used to convey access token. We have to use other technologies for authentication and authorization with OAuth 2.0. Today, I'd like to focus on the authentication and authorization. Here is a requirement from banking customers, bank customers, about authentication and authorization. The first requirement is authentication. We have to support various very customized authentication in OAuth flow, and also we have to use OpenID Connect on top of OAuth. Second one is access control. We have to deny and allow access based on claims in tokens. And we can combine the access control with rate limit. And third one is management of tokens. We have to manage and revoke tokens. Fourth requirement is compliance to the latest standards. In Japan, financial grade API, FAPI of OpenID Foundation is required. We implemented open API system to achieve these requirements. This is a basic picture of open API system. The right-hand side is banks. This is legacy backend and REST API server, and API management is at the center. This is an example service. This is our company's service for open API service for financial customers. Sorry, this is Japanese. However, this picture, the meaning of picture is similar to this one. We developed a SaaS service for banks to open API. And we used open source software to implement this service. Today, I'd like to share our experience to implement this service. There are various open source software around API management and authentication and authorization. We chose Threescale as API management and Keycloak for authorization and authentication. This is because these two software has very complete feature of very wide range of feature, and the activity of the community is very high, and because we use open source for production system, we need support service from vendor. About Threescale and Keycloak, support service is available in Japan from Red Hat. Uh, This is an introduction of a very short introduction of KeyClock. How many of you guys know KeyClock? Oh, great. KeyClock is an open source identity management. Community is led by Red Hat. KeyClock has an identity federation of, using OpenID Connect and OAuth and SAML, and also social login and identity management and authentication. This figure shows what is 3Scale. How many of people know 3Scale? Oh, okay. 3Scale is an open source API management solution. 3Scale has the full feature of API management from developer portal and manager and API gateway. It works on a container platform, Red Hat's OpenShift, and the OKD platform. This is a 3Scale can support OAuth and OpenID Connect in combination with KeyClock. So next I'll talk how we achieved these requirements by using open source software. We implemented these requirements using open source in collaboration with open source community. The first one is authentication. Basic authentication flows works correctly, basically. This is the registration of user. 3Scale and KeyClock has enough feature about that. Also, the basic flow of OAuth and OpenID Connect works correctly. However, there is some issues. First one is we have to use PKCE to protect authorization code. Second one is login screen is very highly customized in Japanese customers. Japanese customers care about the look and feel, and the very customized very customized authentication algorithm and the authentication screen. This is PKCE support for KeyClock. KeyClock did not support PKCE, but we submitted pull request and it is merged. From KeyClock 3.1, PKCE is supported and it is enabled by default. Second one is a highly customized login screen. KeyClock has a template to customize login screen. However, it is not enough for Japanese customers. So we split the login screen application. We prepared another server for login screen and the very customized authentication. However, this server requires a parameter, some parameters from the application. KeyClock cannot forward the parameter from application to this login server, so we submitted the patch pull request, and it is merged now. Second problem is access control. KeyClock only issues tokens, and the access control is out of scope of KeyClock. So we have to handle the access control in API gateway. However, API gateway of 3Scale called Upcast did not support access control using KeyClock access token. So we developed with community. This is access token of KeyClock. The access token of KeyClock is JWT. The format is almost similar to ID token, but this is very specific to KeyCloak. We developed an extension to three scale API gateway called KeyCloak Role Check Policy. This role check policy looks at the claims. KeyCloak, the access token of KeyCloak includes the roles. This role check policy checks the role attribute in API gateway and allow or deny based on these roles. This feature is we submitted the pull request and it is included from 3Scale 2.3. Next one is edge limit policy. We want to control access in combination with rate limit. However, 3Scale only supports the rate limit for only support for to control access based on API key. We developed the new rate limit feature. The purpose of the this rate limit is to protect backend by rate limit. The concurrent connection and the request per seconds and by leaky bucket algorithm and fixed window algorithm and et cetera. Also, this can be combined with the KeyCloak claim of access token. This feature is also we submitted the pull request, and also this feature is included called as a edge limit policy from 3Scale 2.3. Next one is the management of tokens. Okay. KeyCloak has a token endpoint to revoke tokens. KeyCloak's token revocation endpoint is not compliant to RFC. However, KeyCloak has its specific logout endpoints. By calling these logout endpoints, related tokens are revocated. However, only the this endpoint is not enough for API management. The token is revoked only in KeyCloak. We have to ask to KeyCloak whether token is revoked or not. This is token introspection endpoints of KeyCloak. We implemented the token introspection policy in the 3Scale API gateway to ask KeyCloak whether token is valid or not. This is also included in now the latest 3Scale. Oh, I don't have enough time. This is how API is called in the latest 3Scale. First, the application calls the API to 3Scale API gateway. And at first, token introspection is called to see the access token is valid or not. Next, access control is processed in the role check policy and edge limit policy. And the next, the extract necessary information is extracted from access token, and the necessary information is set in header, and the 3Scale API gateway calls backend REST API server with necessary information in header. The last topic is the compliance to the latest standard called FAPI. FAPI is being standardized in OpenID Foundation. It is composed of part 1 and part 2 and germ. FAPI is the hardening of the OAuth and OpenID Connect for financial industries. FAPI is now still implemented as draft. However, it is very strongly promoted in Japanese banking industry. This is quoted from the report of Japanese Bankers Associations. FAPI is described in the report. So we have to prepare for FAPI in advance because it takes time to implement. We investigated whether Keycloak is compliant to FAPI, and we found some problems and reported to the JIRA of Keycloak. This is the current status. Almost all issues are resolved now, and thanks to the pull request of my colleague. I'll introduce some highlights. The very big feature is the hold of token mechanism. Hold of token mechanism is a binding a secret which proves the token, which proves the possession of the token with the access token, and the API server verifies the binding. There are two standards. First one is using TLS technology, and the second one is token OAuth 2.0 token binding technology. FAPI requires either of them. We implemented the specification called MTLS for Keycloak, and we gave up the token binding. It was too difficult to implement. The MTLS specification is now included in the latest version of Keycloak. Also, the signature algorithm of Keycloak is hard-coded, and we refactored the signature algorithm, and the Keycloak now can support various types of algorithm. Okay, this is the progress of the Keycloak. This is 3.0 about 1 year ago. This is the latest version of Keycloak. Thanks to our work, the red point is increased. Okay, there are some issues, however, I don't have enough time. first one is the cookie of Keycloak. Keycloak was originally developed for single sign-on, and it issues cookies to browsers. However, for API authorization, cookie is not necessary, and it has a side. We encountered some side effects, and we had to remove cookies in load balancers. It was a very bad point. Second one is difficulty in container technologies. Current version of 3Scale only works on container. However, container is very difficult to learn, and the version up is very frequent. It is also a remaining problem. We have to discuss with the community to improve these problems. Okay, I used my time. Okay, thank you very much.